Elon Musk says Tesla shareholders are voting to approve his $56 billion pay package. The Tesla CEO even thanked them in a post on X. The shareholders are also expected to approve a proposal to move the EV maker's legal home to Texas. Musk's $56 billion paycheck, first agreed in 2018, is the largest remuneration terms in U.S. corporate history. A shareholder approval could allay investor concerns about Musk's future at the company. Earlier this year, a Delaware judge voided the compensation deal after a small investor sued. But it remains unclear if the court will accept the shareholders' vote. Musk, meanwhile, is also facing a lawsuit from shareholders accusing him of making unlawful profits from the sale of Tesla stocks between 2021 and 2022. Hungarian Foreign Affairs and Trade Minister Szijjártó Péter is set to meet with Philippine counterpart Enrique Manalo this afternoon. Szijjártó is now in Manila ahead of that meeting. This is part of his official tour of Southeast Asia. The Hungarian official will also meet with Philippine Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual, as well as Migrant Worker Secretary Hans Kakdak. Budapest is a key partner of Manila on education, agriculture, water technology, culture, and sports. The Philippine President signs a bill forming the Negros Island region. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. enacted one of his pet measures Thursday to incorporate the Negros provinces, Siquijor and Central Philippines, into one administrative region. Now, Marcos in his speech says the move will position Negros as a hub for development in the Visayas. He also believes this will improve locals' access to government services and address uneven growth.
For decades now, Negrenses have endured the rigors of sea travel, unnecessary expenses, bureaucratic red tape, inefficiency that this arrangement has brought, especially when there is a need to urgently access government services from regional centers. The new Negros Island region will be a bulwark of greater growth, as well as a conduit for more effective and efficient delivery of essential services in the region. We envision as well the NIR as one of the centers of development in the Visayas, further accelerating socio-economic development for the millions of Negrenses and providing strategic convergence.
Also signed into law as a measure to improve the country's real property valuation and assets assessment system.
This new law is born out of the necessity and the realization that there is a need to enhance the country's tax collection system so we can generate revenues, generate jobs, investments all over the country. No longer will we rely on the outdated valuation system.
The total assets of Philippine banks climbed in April, buoyed by growth in loans. Preliminary data from the Philippine Central Bank show local lenders' total assets were at 25.49 trillion pesos as of the end of April. That figure is 12% higher than what was recorded a year ago. Month on month, however, it is lower by 0.7%. Banks' total loan portfolio, meanwhile, stood at 13.46 trillion pesos. That's 1.8% higher month-on-month and 11% higher year-on-year. The Philippine Supreme Court orders the reopening of graft cases involving real estate firm Delta Ventures Resources of the late tycoon Roberto Ongpin. The cases stem from the granting of 660 million pesos in loans in 2009 by the Development Bank of the Philippines to Delta Ventures. The court said that dismissal of the cases by the Sandigan Bayan was improper because the standard of clear lack of probable cause was not observed. In the cases filed before the Sandigan Bayan, the ombudsman alleged then DBP officials took advantage of their positions and conspired with Delta Ventures for the loan.